It's been tough for Superman fans having their favorite character totally left out of the ad campaign for Justice League. And it's not like Henry Cavill isn't in the movie. But of course, everyone else understands that the DCEU, understandably, is a little bit concerned about pulling another doomsday, an infamous moment, not just in DCEU, but movie history, where a very big movie saw popular opinion turn on it, do a complete 180 in an instant. It was pretty amazing to witness, actually. So don't count on seeing Superman until the actual movie, or maybe sooner. We'll see what happens. But when he does show up, I'm sure that you've noticed that all DC fans are pretty adamant, including myself, that he has a particular look, right? He's got to have the black suit, and he's got to have ideally long hair. Now, I say ideally on that last one. I qualify that last one because it doesn't look like we're going to get it. We would like to have it, and you'll see why as we go over the history of this story. But in a couple of behind-the-scenes shots for Justice League, we've seen Henry Cavill, and he's sporting his typical slick-backed farm boy hairstyle. So maybe it's a misdirect? I don't know. If he can just have it for a moment, even. Anyway, things aren't looking good for the black suit. That's because when they recently released the Justice League Twitter emojis, everybody has a face but Henry Cavill, right? But he did get a logo. And his logo was his traditional logo, but it was not so traditional, black and red. So why does this matter beyond DC films being thematically and literally darker than Marvel movies? And also Hollywood loving to put superheroes in black, especially when things get serious, when things get real. Well, that's because the death and return of Superman is one of his most famous stories. And we're talking about a character that doesn't have a lot of famous stories. And when I say famous stories, I mean ones that have truly stuck around and have represented major turning points for the character. So with the first half of this famous Superman story already crammed into the last few minutes of Batman v Superman, fans, both serious and casual, I'm talking about Superman. I consider myself a casual Superman fan, but I'm hardcore DC. And like many of you, I would like to see at least the second half of the story get a little more care and attention. By the way, speaking of serious and wearing black, that usually also means a darker turn for a character, narrative-wise, which isn't part of the Death and Return of Superman storyline. He's actually not around for, you know, it's interesting. Even in his own major story, Superman was kind of like having stuff done to him, and it was a lot about how everybody else reacted to it. But anyway, composer Danny Elfman recently revealed in an interview that he has done a twisted version of the famous Superman theme by John Williams to be played in a moment in the film, Justice League, where we're not really sure which side he, in this case Superman, is on. Oh, a moment! It seems like we're going to be rushed again. But it's important to note that this does come from the comics. This is rooted in the comics. As usual, they're cramming, this is particularly for the DCEU, they're cramming two really big storylines together into one. So Darkseid famously brainwashed Superman into fighting for him in the Legacy story and Superman the Animated Series, and also in the comics he famously did it to Supergirl. And an evil Superman has always been a tantalizing idea to explore. As a casual Superman fan, and a huge, you can't be a bigger Batman fan than myself, I've always been particularly drawn to it, which I guess is why I'm okay with the experimentation that they've been doing with Superman in the DCEU. But it might be difficult, speaking of the DCEU, for them to explore it because they haven't firmly established good Superman. You know, this isn't really a change. Batman seems pretty freaking convinced. I don't know where the heck that comes from. I think it's either, it might be a combination of guilt and self-reflection. But to me, the DCEU has done a great job of setting up an indifferent Superman who's still in that crossroads, who's still at that fork in the road, if he should be good or if he should be evil. And maybe here, he goes evil first, it seems, just for a moment, but I don't know. I hope that they would potentially explore that. I mean, these things really should be being explored in Man of Steel solo movies, but those aren't happening. But let's, here are the incredibly important moments in the Return of Superman story, which will either be crammed into Justice League, or maybe saved for Man of Steel 2, a Superman solo movie, or maybe just hinted at. But anyway, so after he's killed in action, taking down Doomsday, Superman is buried but his body has moved. Now, in the comics, it was a mystery as to where it went, but of course, in the movies, we know it was Martha. Then, after a little bit of a hiatus, both for the character and the comic, four new Supermen appeared on the scene, with everyone wondering where they came from and if one of them was the real Superman returned. One, this is important, one was the Metropolis Kid, a.k.a. Superboy, a name he didn't take too kindly to. Who would know he would become the most famous version of the character? But he turned out to be a clone with both Superman and Lex Luthor DNA, fighting the two sides of his very nature. Great idea. And this character goes on to join the Teen Titans, and most famously, a little show called Young Justice, where he's one half of that show's Ross and Rachel. Now, the next Superman to show up is John Henry Irons, a.k.a. Steel, a military weapons designer, a little bit like a little lower-level Tony Stark, who makes his own suit and wields a hammer. John Henry, get the reference? He went on to become a popular character in the comics and Superman the Animated Series, as did his daughter, but these days, unfortunately, both have been benched. But you know, they could come back in the DCEU. Then there was the not-so-convincing cyborg Superman. I don't think anybody thought that was Superman. But maybe he came back. That was a patch job, maybe. Who knows? But he was actually revealed to be missing astronaut Hank Henshaw in disguise, who would go on to become a Superman villain, who, of course, today is Martian Manhunter's alter ego, with the original Hank Henshaw being a villain on Supergirl's show. And then finally, there was the last son of Krypton, who went all Red Hood, killing criminals instead of apprehending them. And he was the most likely candidate to be the real Superman returned. But instead, it was revealed that he was the one who'd stolen Superman's body and put it in a Kryptonian regeneration matrix, which was powering this mysterious figure to be able to pose as a new Superman. But it was actually the Eradicator, a Superman villain in disguise. Now, Superman broke out of the regeneration matrix, weakened, and with 90s-esque longer hair. Think Mark Wahlberg in Transformers, Dylan O'Brien, or Harry Styles. Perfectly coiffed. And in fact, the new look was so popular and such a welcome change of pace for the character, along with his black suit, that he kept the long hair until he got married, because Clark Kent ain't walking down the aisle like no damn hippie. And his new black suit wasn't just fashionable and slimming either. Because of his time in the regeneration matrix, he was still weakened, because, you know, the Eradicator had been siphoning off powers from him, and when he went into it, he was clinically dead. So the black suit allowed Superman to absorb and process yellow sunlight much, much faster than usual. And this allowed him not only to continue to use his powers and operate as Superman, but to heal while he wore it. And if Batman ends up making his black suit in the DCEU, well, then I feel Superman fans, hardcore Superman fans, will finally lose their shit for real. They've been right on the edge for a while now. And in fact, Superman fans hate the way the DCEU treats their favorite character, if you haven't caught on to that already in this video. And I often notice that in large part, they align with hardcore Marvelites against the DCEU. Sad. But true. And, you know, I think the DCEU would be wise to give Superman a little bit more respect to bring those fans back into the fold. So as you can see, the black suit represents a very important time in Superman's life as a character and as a character in the comics. It's when he not only had to recover from a traumatic experience, but which also saw the introduction of several very important and popular supporting characters. And the Darkseid mind control stuff, even though it's being thrown in here, that's important to Superman mythology as well. So now you know why all of this is important, and even if it is rushed, you will be able to pick up even the slightest of references. So I look forward to continuing the discussion down below with you about Superman in the upcoming Justice League movie, how he should look, and the respect that this story should hopefully get, and then of course what it will get. So again, I look forward to continuing the conversation down below, and you can, as always, check out some more videos right now.